What is going on, guys? We're here with OLT Playoffs. And yeah, we got Kantor's Extra Shine. They both have Sticky Webs plus Aurora Veil. And these Shuckles got up their hazards. Extra Shine Shuckle got Toxic and now used Encore. So, what he's trying to do is he trying to lose? Oh, it's Final Gambit. No, I was about to say, is he trying to lose his Shuckle and have to still be Encored? And that is what he accomplished. This is Encored and Toxic, which means, man, if he can go for like a Z-Renance to get a speed boost. But he's gonna save the Z-Renance because he wants to get the speed boost after the hail goes up. Yeah, now he can go for Z-Renance. But now the Veil goes up. Yeah, Ampulse keeps asking my man Sorry if he wants to play, but yeah, Sorry still has to prep. Probably, they're probably playing on Friday, I think. Kanto can, like, I think freeze dry to it KOs the mana fee. But it's the better play. I think the better play is getting up the Aurora Veil. Just so that I think Bulu is gonna be the one that's gonna be taking the hit. Okay, Moonblast. What? Moonblast? Does it not have freeze dry? Okay, that's really bad for him. This Manaphy might just sweep now because Surf kills. So if the I don't know why he didn't get up Aurora Veil then, if he only had Moonblast. Maybe I'm missing something here. Okay, it doesn't have Ice Beam. Does Surf do more than Ice Beam? I don't think it does more. I think it was probably just Psychic Manaphy because that helps in the stall matchup. But yeah, Extra can now get up his Aurora Veil. I can also just click Freeze Dry here, it doesn't really matter. But yeah, Aurora Veil is fine. It's leftovers. Oh no, Grassy Terrain, okay. I'm tripping. I didn't. Okay, so I got interrupted real quick. What happened? Let me just go back. So you got up Toxic Spikes and you got put the Bad Blooded Greninja. Okay, one Hypnosis missed. Oh, he didn't get put to bed. He used Taunt on Hypnosis. Okay. Yeah, I do like Veil versus Veil. This is not for me. I'm not a fan of this game. But yeah, this Greninja usually is like Ice Beam Dark Pulse, I think, is the coverage that they run. It could also be regular spikes. But yeah, obviously he taunts so that his Tita the NTD, I'm pretty sure he's just gonna attack because exactly the taunt was so obvious, and if he goes for Dragon Dance there, a ton of Veil gets wasted and he can obviously knock Dragon Dance up, so like, and he also takes poison damage, so attacking was the better play. Does he trying to have like, does he have Flash Cannon or like, okay, he just tried to sub to stall out the Veil, but that didn't work. So yeah, Extra Shine wins this game. This game's over. I mean, he was able to get up his Veil and Kanto didn't get up his Veil. And man, if he put in a lot of work. I mean, okay, not a lot of work, but like, he got rid of the Ninetales and it weakened the Bulu. Wait, it's Adamant, really? Where's the subtrend on Veil Webs? I mean, I don't really understand. I mean, I understand why it's subtrend because he has Toxic Spikes. Adamant is only viable, Tita, don't use Jolly Kids. What? I mean, he's talking about Dugtrio outspeeding it, but Dugtrio is getting banned soon anyway. But yeah, Dugtrio is still allowed at the moment in the tour. So yeah, then he's still correct. Yeah, game is over. But yeah, it's a best of three. We're going to go on to the next one. Yeah, if the games are short like this, I'm obviously going to do every game in the entire best of three in one video. But sometimes there's like 40-minute games. Then I'll do multiple videos. Yeah, Exoshine is up 1-0. This is like standard rail that my man Sorry uses, but it had a Shuckle instead of, I think, Mega, no, not Mega Mawile. What was in the last slot? I can't think about it at the moment. But yeah, game 2 already started. Kanto brought this more stally-ish looking team. That stall is a semi-stall. So if I recall correctly, this is a team that ABR made. But he might have changed up the teams to catch his opponent, I guess, off guard. But it's probably just a matchup call. Like, Kanto just thinks that this has a good matchup versus the offense that Extra has. I think I had him on the other side, so I'm gonna switch again. So this is Helmet Tangrowth if he didn't change the team. I think the Magearna was AV. I don't remember though. I think it's AV with Iron Head to help versus Calmant Magearna and Calmant Clef. Like, Iron Head still does consistent damage to those mons. I didn't expect this from you exactly. That's why he brought it. But yeah, this is just the free. Like, Tangrowth is forced out here, obviously. Magearna's his only play here. That is absolutely nothing because it's Assault Vest. AB Magearna. Yeah, ABR made this team. Or like, it's ABR spread. I think this is, it's either Max Spadef or it's pretty, almost Max Spadef Magearna. And it's actually pretty nice. Like, it has a really great amount of Spadef. Like, you can check Ash, Grin, or Grin in general, pretty nice. And I think it runs 16 special attack, so Ice Beam, Oko, Zygarde, but I don't really remember what else the investment is or what it does. I mean, if I'm Kanto here, I would, like, usually you don't play these teams super aggressive, but I would probably predict the Excadrill here. Like, if he has a move to hit the Excadrill, he can go for that. If he doesn't have a move to hit it, he can double switch. Wow. Wow, why? What? What? Why did he go to Grin? Did he predict him to break the Excadrill? Which means he would have gone into... No, I don't really understand that play. I mean, I guess he just wanted to get momentum and he had the sack. I don't know. I mean, Kanto's play was fine because he would have gotten damage on the drill. Like, you don't have to play stall aggressive. This is Mold Breaker anyways, and this, I assume this is the rocker. It's the only rocker on the team. Yeah. So even if he doubled into Mega Sableye breaking that, he could still get up rocks anyway. At first I was thinking you could double to Sableye and prevent rocks, but obviously there's no point. That's also why he didn't lead with Sableye, because this has Mold Breaker anyway. But yeah, he's gonna go for Giga Drain or Earthquake. I actually don't remember the entire moveset on this. I think it's Sleep Powder and Giga Drain. HP Ice and Earthquake. I didn't think it had Earthquake actually. I just remember HP Ice, Giga Drain, Sleep Powder. Unless he changed it to double AV, but I think this is fifth death. Helps the team with Lopunny, even though Pex and Zapdos also check Lopunny. What else does this Tangrowth help him with if it's fifth death? It helps him with Mega Gallade, even though that one is not common. I'm pretty sure the Dougie Scarf on this team, by the way. Is this Zapdos Z-move? I don't remember if it is. So he sacks off a drill, and actually, never mind, he doesn't. It ate. And so the last move on the drill is obviously Spin. It doesn't have Iron Head. It's just a lead drill. The Mimikyu is a Life Orb, and Gyarados is Mega? Oh, it could also be Z-move Mimikyu, but I think the Magearna is Z-move. Oh yeah, Tangrowth is a really nice check for Gyarados, so getting this poisoned is nice for extra. If this is Fist Def, it still eats a hit from Gyarados from that range. So I assume he's gonna go into his he's a Magearna or Lele here. Yeah, he goes into Gyarados. If this Gyarados is like Taunt or Sub, so Sableye can't Will-O Wisp, this is actually amazing for him. If Zapdos is Fist Def, it still eats a hit and... But I assume... Yeah, I assume this Gyarados will do a lot of damage to Kanto's team. Like, he's gonna stay in regular form, obviously, so Giga Drain doesn't get super effective. If this for some reason is not Mega and it's Sky Strike, then I messed up, but I thought it's Mega on this team. I mean, I haven't really seen this specific team, but I have seen these type of HO teams, and there was... Sometimes it's Mega, sometimes it's Z. But usually I've seen Mega a bit more often. I mean, extra knows if the Tangrowth is Assault Vest or not. I haven't calculated that if Tangrowth is Fist Def. It took Surling from an Earthquake, so maybe it's not even Fist Def. Let me calculate that real quick. I don't want to give you guys like wrong information. Yeah, Zapdos eats any one hit. I don't know about Ice Fang though. It eats Waterfall for sure. That's a bulky dose. But yeah, let's just say Excadrill versus Tangrowth. Yeah, so if it was AV, it would have done 17 to 20, so it was definitely a Fist Def. So he switched out and it's a red card Mimikyu. So that makes me 100% think that he's not Mega Gyarados. Because he didn't Mega there. Like, if he was Mega, he could have Mega eaten up the discharge. Yeah, I guess now it all makes sense. He's probably Sky Strike then. So this is red card, this is Sky Strike then. I don't know, this could be Ayapapa, however you pronounce that. This could be Scarf. I haven't calculated the damage on AV Magearna. How much did it do? Did 16. But the Pex runs Spadef, but since this is not life of Mimikyu, this can still eat it up. I assume the Shadow Claw is gonna do around like half. Like 55 maybe? Okay, 50. It's just gonna recover here and the Mimikyu is gonna SD up and eventually the Mimikyu is gonna crit fish if extra stays in. Just Gav Duggy, I think it runs Edge on this team. Does it run Stone Edge? If it runs Stone Edge, it can help wrench the Gyarados later. It helps him trap the Lele, but Lele is not a problem at the moment for him. As long like Magearna's still healthy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that Tangrowth is gonna eat a player off with ease because it's Fist Def. So he's gonna go for the Sleep Powder here, I think. Giga Drain, wow. Does he not have Sleep Powder? It's Helmet, right? Yeah, see, it's Helmet. Does he not have Sleep Powder? I'm a bit confused. Because if this player off hits, Sableye is gone, yeah. And it's looking bad for Kanto. I guess does he not have Sleep Powder? I didn't want to risk it. Crazy how Mimikyu is putting in work, yeah. I mean, to be fair, if Kanto like stayed in with his packs and recovered, the Mimikyu could have always SD'd up and like he always had to haze. And eventually Mimikyu would have crit him, so I understand why he switched out, but like this is rough for him. Probably gonna go Pexy and Haze. Because he needs the Magearna healthy, obviously, for the Tapu Lele. Zapdos actually took the rocks. That is helpful for extra, because if it takes rocks again, it's going to be potentially in plus one Gyarados range. I haven't run the Kulk, but I assume it could be. So he's going to haze here and then recover. Okay, recover first. I thought haze was a fine play, but it works anyway. Okay, recover again was fine. So Heart Magearna here, obviously, this is going to go for Psychic. Do some chip. And there's a free Volt Switch for him. Oh, Iron Head, okay. Alright, just in case he stayed in, I guess. I don't know. Wait, why did my main story say AVR stuff? Exactly, it's for Combat Clef and for opposing Combat Magearna, but mainly for Combat Clef. That Flash Cannon did 5. Yeah, but now we can run the Kulk if Dougie kills. If it's Element Scarf, it might actually kill. Otherwise, he's just gonna go into his pecs here. If Dougie can't kill, I can run the Kulk real quick. Dougie, it's a Scarf Dougie, but I'm just gonna put Focus Sash versus Magearna. I'm pretty sure this is offensive Magearna. Earthquake kills, yeah. If the Magearna doesn't have HP. So Magearna run like 200 HP, let me run that Kulk for that set. Still does 60 admin. So if it's Adamant, it probably still kills. I assume he's Jolly Scarf. But yeah, if this doesn't have HP, it's a guaranteed kill anyway. Oh, it could be Sugar Magearna, that's what he's talking about. Who's my Z-move then? Mimikyu, Red Card Mimikyu. It's Red Card Z-move. No, your Z-move one is Gyarados, I think. Yeah, this could definitely be Sugar, I didn't even think about it. I was thinking something like Ayapapa Berry. But yeah, Sugar is a good option, I didn't think. I don't know why that didn't cross my mind. But he goes into Dougie, and now we're gonna see if it's Sugar. Like, I've seen, like, extra has used it before, I'm pretty sure, so that's definitely an option, yeah. Yep, Shoka gets a crit, still doesn't kill. Goes for Shift Gear. Wait, this is Scarf Dougie, why did he Shift Gear? No. This is Scarf Dougie, why was Shift Gear to play? Why does the entire Smoktus... Did I not get it in the Smoktus shield? The crit didn't matter, dude. Scarf Dougie outspeeds you. Yeah. So he's gonna off. Oh, is he not Scarf? What? Like, Scarf Dougie outspeeds Magearna. I'm pretty sure after Shift Gear. I'm hella confused by this. So is he not Scarf Dougie? I'm really confused, I don't get it. So he's gonna recover here. Oh, Scald, yeah. Scald is the better play, what am I saying? I don't understand, I thought the Dougie was Scarf. I understand, let me explain. Okay, I'm tripping. If he kills the Magearna with Scarf Dougie, then the Gyarados gets a free setup. Hey, this is the problem, like, I just can't think clear today at all, like. I'm not gonna talk about my, I don't know. It's like, because I have like, I didn't sleep enough, got some problems going on here, but it's fine. Yes, he has the outdated version of your team. Almost every set is different. Yeah, because if the Gyarados got a free Dragonlance, pretty much just won. And what he can do now is he can... I mean, this is... I think this is still a pretty tough position for Kanto. He can spam Haze, expecting the Dragonlance to count, because Haze has more PP than Dragonlance. But if this Gyarados has sub, then the game is probably over right here if he stays in and Haze is on a sub. Yeah, like, this was an example of me not thinking long term. That's what I do when I'm tired. It's fine. Yep, it is substitute, so he's gonna spam Stone Edge here, I assume, or whatever rock move he has. I don't know, maybe he has Rock Tomb. Goes back in the packs. This is gonna... Huh. This game is over, like... He can Sky Strike here, and then the game is over. No, actually, it's not... Because he can switch out on the Sky Strike and get Regenerator. It's Intimidate, it's not Moxie, so that's also why it made me think that he was Mega, because on the Z-move set, you sometimes see... Like, on the non-Mega Gyarados, on the regular Z-move set, you usually see Moxie. Well, not usually, but sometimes. We still don't know, it could still be Mega, like, I'm, like, really thrown off. But he's not Mega Evolving, so I guess it's not Mega. Yeah, I don't know. The mana ration was off this game, I have to apologize, I don't know. I said I don't know way too often. So it is Mega after all. So I got trolled. Scarf Aerial A is gonna not even break the sub. What does Aerial Ace do? It's for Heracross. For this guy that's asking in the chat. But yeah, someone already said Heracross. It's obviously for Hera. Like, what else would it be for? I was kind of excited for the series, but I didn't really like the series, to be fair. Like I gotta be honest with you guys. Like, as in the sense how entertaining this was, this wasn't like the best to watch for me, but it's still fine. We will watch. I don't think there's any other series today, and yeah, I'm not recording Snake Draft. I'm too tired. Like, you guys can see, I'm already messing up here. Definitely not gonna record Snake Draft. But congratulations to Extra Shine, who actually 2-0'd. I mean, it's crazy though, cause Extra, like, most of the time he always brings some offense most of the time, right? And he still wins. Oh, it's Zigo Ninja with low kick. We never see this. We never saw the Z-move user. Yeah, you have seen me guessing that I thought this was Mega. First I thought it was Mega, then I thought it was Z-move because he brought it in on the Tangrowth. But obviously, if he doesn't Mega Evolve, the Tangrowth was poisoned. He can still spam Dragon Dance and the Tangrowth gets, like, chipped. And, like, it's still forced out. Like, so it all makes sense. And what, he switched out on the Zapdos earlier? I saw that confirmed that he was not Mega when he switched out on the Zapdos. But I must have had a good reason. Where's the play? Oh, he went hard Mimikyu on a discharge. Yeah, it was still fine. It's crazy how Mimikyu can actually... Mimikyu could actually put in some work with his team, because he played it smart and he got the Toxic on the Tangrowth. Tangrowth obviously is like a good, great check for Mimikyu otherwise. And he can never bring the Majorna out, because it's nice to check the opposing Majorna and mainly the Tapu Lele. And this packs, they run Respedef at the moment to check Zard Y and Ash Greninja, even though he already has this for Ash Greninja. It's a nice secondary check for opposing Midjourney. Yeah, Sableye was forced to not mega, and yeah, just got bopped with the Mimikyu. When do you ever see Mimikyu putting in that much work with God? I might have to put Mimikyu in the thumbnail. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you still enjoyed despite me messing up at some points. And see you with more ulti series. Yeah, so someone asked me what matchups I'm hyped for. Let me answer real quick in the video. I'm gonna answer this right now to you in the video, my man. Extra Shine replied to the threat. Let me pause it. So we got the matchups here, and so I'm hyped for my man Sorry vs Ampo, because one, it's a rematch. They played yesterday in Smog Tours. They played in OE Room Premier League. I don't know if they played before that, but I think they have met on the ladder a lot, but ladder doesn't really count, it's not in tour. I don't know if they played in tour other than that. So I'm hyped for that, just because Sorry's my friend and I really want to see him do well. But I'm now usually I'm fine with Ampo winning as well, but I gotta root for my man here. Other matches I'm hyped for, obviously, Sejumas vs Blunder seems like a really great match, and I feel like this can definitely go either way. And High vs Lefties is like one of the games, like this is like fire. Like Lefties is always one of my favorites to win ulti. My other main favorite is obviously ABR, the ulti champion. But there's Suchtres was going in earlier, so I don't know if I have to put him on my favorite list for now, but you definitely have to watch out for this guy. But yeah, the last game, is there another game? Like Ojama versus ABR, yeah, it's a cool game, but like, I feel like ABR is just way too solid, like he's gonna win this for sure. But it's still gonna be good games, and I'm also interested in this series because, Leonis and Suchtres are like the two Germans in this tournament. And the playoffs, so yeah, I'm rooting for Leonis, and I think he's definitely like I've seen a lot of people rooting for like predicting Kickasa to win this, but I think Leonis can definitely take it. Like he's really solid, and he was dominating the ladder and like in a cycle. I know that doesn't like dominating the ladder doesn't mean that you win a tour as well, but like he's definitely really good. Like don't sleep on him, like don't sleep on these two Germans at all. Thank you guys for watching. Just wanted to give some info because someone asked which matches I'm hyped for. Like basically those three, four matches I talked about. I don't know too much about comp, but this is also a cool game. Like, I think Karim's misses some ladder hero. Like generally I'm always interested, and I'm like the people that I don't know much about, I'm just like kind of like hyped. Like I see new. Like I haven't seen them play in tournaments before, so like I don't know what to expect. It's definitely cool, but yeah, like Lead Drill keeps importing work. It's crazy. Like I've also played this team on the versus this team on the ladder and put in some work versus me. Or I also used something like this. Yeah, I've used some Lead Drill, and surprisingly, it does more than you think sometimes. And yeah, but anyways, I'm out. I think the next game is scheduled for like Wednesday, but I'm not 100% on that. But you guys will see. Like you, I'm gonna keep my eyes open. I'm gonna make sure to catch almost every game live. Like I said, hopefully next time on a day where I slept better and I don't have personal issues, so I can focus better. But yeah, hope you still enjoyed. And yeah, I'm kind of repeating myself. Have a good day and goodbye. Fantastic day. Yeah, nice and messed up my outro. Classic. Peace out, friends.